The challenges that the continent is facing in terms of developing science and technology and innovation on the continent is one, is that the culture for science and technology is still low. We need to build that culture. It's a culture that has to be built right from, you know, grassroots all the way. That's something that we need to address. The other challenge that we have is confidence in our own local, you know, scientists and experts. We need actually to have confidence in our in our scientists and experts. The other thing is that most of the research that we've done, you find that you know, people have got results, but to take them to, you know, to the end user, what is called the valley of death, that again is an area where I find that the culture of entrepreneurship is not there. I mean, as long as people have published and there's going to journals, they are happy. But at the end of the day, you know, what we're saying is, can it be science just for the sake of science, or is it science that should be there actually to change lives? You know, so that's a part of the challenge that we face. And of course, enabling environment. Funding is only one of the factors in the so-called enabling environment. You know, policies that actually are made and need to be implemented, support in terms of funding, you know, infrastructure, but those are really could put them in the broader context of enabling environment. The issue of patenting, we really need to put it in context. I mean, we have all complained about, you know, I mean, how about patents and all that. You know, the issue of patents, I think it's an issue of capacity building. People learn about it when they actually go through the process of patenting. But if our research constituents is not taking products to the end user, you find that they will not explore how much, what sort of issues exist in their own countries, even that they deals with patents. For instance, I mean, in Kenya, I mean, we've got offices responsible for dealing with issues of patents. They can even do capacity building, well-trained people that are in those offices, but actually we are not using them. So it's still something which, to me, the way I look at it is, we are standing on the edge of the on the bank of a river, and not yet getting to the river itself. Say, okay, what is it? How cold is the water in there? Have we tried the system and really, you know, exhausted so that we see that we don't have structures in place? The real issue is that we have some of these institutions, but we're not utilizing them. So this is a two-way process. One is those institutions that have been set up to deal with issues of patent, I mean, like the Kenya Patenting Office, reaching out to the scientists, and also the scientists get to know what is involved. I know that we also talk of, oh, patenting is expensive, but the issue is, can we put it in context whereby we have a specific case and say as how far we can go? So I would say that, yes, it's an issue, but there are structures that we still need to exhaust and really figure out where the problem is. That's the way we look at it. Okay. Now, in as far as NEPAD, the African Union are concerned, we are also helping out in actually building capacity in the issues, to the issue of patent. As you might have heard, there is the Pan-African Institute on, you know, intellectual property, PIPO. The whole idea actually is to see how actually we can also be part and parcel of, you know, addressing the issues of patent. But the thing is, here's a good road, or here's a road, and then you have not even tried it, and you're saying, oh, but this road is not good, it's too bumpy. No, try the road first and then we see where the bumps are, so that you can even them out.